Hey friends, welcome to One Flight Down. Welcome to the Terry Isle Tasting Lounge. And let's give a huge warm welcome to my special guest, Shane, from Shane's Craft Beer Review.
Yeah, you know what, I'm very excited to be around. I've been wanting to come here for quite a while. I kind of sad that I missed coming to the Terry Isle Basement Pub. But yeah. You know what, I'm here at the Terry Isle Tasting Lounge and that's almost as good.
It's a slightly different experience, but it's still the Terry Isle Pub. Just
That's
come
right.
in and join us and have a beer.
Absolutely.
Today's beer is from basically right over there, right? This outside that window.
It's right over there.
It's from Little Brown Jug. Seriously, this place is a 2-minute walk from my home. This is the Aussie Pale Ale. This one comes in at 5% alcohol, and this is not one we had when we were there earlier tonight, I believe.
No, I did not have this one either.
All right, so let's crack this one open. Healthy Shakluk. A Shakluk is almost always better when someone's wearing a Shakluk shirt.
Well, we were talking about this earlier, the Shakluk is almost becoming universal.
Yeah, verb now.
So many people use it, like I use it. I know Chase uses it, and a bunch of other beer viewers. It's a common word now.
Yeah,
and
so
I love that. And hey, congratulations for that.
I have to credit my friend Ken, who's not here. So
he's not.
So maybe I won't credit him. We'll see. All right, what do we got on the nose here? I'm getting a lot. I'm getting a slight sort of that like kind of bready note you get.
Right. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
But not much. It's kind of nondescript.
Yeah, it's like you said, the breadiness, just a touch of like that hoppy kind of smell. A
little bit.
Again, nondescript, a hop.
Yeah.
You can't tell what it is for sure.
I mean, yeah, it's not, it wouldn't put you off. You bring this to your nose, I would want to keep drinking this.
Sure. Yeah. I'm always good with drinking stuff like this. I'm good at drinking anything, really.
Maybe we should see what it tastes like.
We should.
All right. Cheers.
Cheers. Okay.
I've had this before, and it's still different than I expected it to be. There's more of a bite at the end than I was expecting out of this.
Yeah, it does have that hot bite at the back end. But I'm finding, it's got, a really, a dry hop flavor.
Yeah.
Right from probably the, I don't want to say the very start, but, mid to late. It's just like that dry kind of hoppiness. Almost like a raw hop flavor.
Yeah. Like I get the hops and it's funny, I think of a pale ale, I expect a little more like a fruitiness up front. And you get a bit of that, but it's like a really dry finish. My mouth is give me more liquid.
Yeah, it's a very dry finish, that's for sure. When you take that sip, and it's like your mouth almost kind of, for me, it's a weird description, I know, I apologize. It's almost like my tongue kind of latches to the top of my mouth.
Okay.
Right? Because it's that dry.
Yeah. I get the more, my tongue, from something that dry, it almost goes, it retreats. My tongue is just pulling back.
Yeah. Sorry, that's probably a better description of what I was trying to talk about. It's just your tongue pulls back, but mine goes back and to the top because it's so dry at the back end. Not that it's terrible.
It's not
a bad tasting beer. Don't get me wrong. It's just a different experience.
Yeah. Yeah. It's also, you couldn't drink this all the time because you just want to keep drinking more things to wet your mouth a bit more.
Right. Yeah, because it's very dry.
Yeah.
That dryness is really, I probably wouldn't have more than one of these because I think that dryness, and it is very dry. I mean, it's not just a slight dry. It's very dry. And I think that would probably be off-putting for me after one.
Yeah. Yeah, you couldn't have a lot of these.
I don't think I would have more than one of this. Not that it's a bad beer. Don't get me wrong. It's not a bad tasting beer. It's just very, very dry.
Yeah, it's not something you could pound back 3 or 4 of them. I've had this one a few times, and it's always been this followed by something else. And I think that's kind of the way to enjoy it.
Well, this might be nice to break up like a a sweeter beer.
Yep.
You know, like you get a nice, if you get a like an amber ale, especially this time of year in the fall, get an amber ale that's pretty sweet, because some of the amber ales can be sweet depending on what you get.
Yeah.
This might be nice to kind of break it up, just to break up that sweetness that you have.
Yeah, like or even like a honey, like a honey golden ale, something like that.
Right, yeah, for sure. Yeah. Yeah, just to, like I said, just to break up the sweetness. And this would definitely break up your sweetness.
Yeah, it would definitely would. Yeah, it's a great beer. It's got its place, but yeah, it's just not the kind of beer you're going to pound back a bunch. But,
yeah, absolutely, yeah.
But not every beer is designed to be that. And I'm sure, well, maybe in Australia that's what they do. Because it is an Aussie Pale Ale.
That's true. And I don't know, outside of a Foster's, which is, I mean, I understand it. Nobody in Australia actually drinks. It's just a bullshit.
But like that,
Australian beer.
But that's what, if somebody said Australian beer, that's what pops in your head first.
Oh, of course.
It's like somebody saying Canadian beer and they think of Molson Canadian. And
that's correct. Yeah.
You know, you go to a bar and you can't find Molson Canadian.
If you can't find a good Molson Canadian in a Canadian bar, like, just leave the country. Because like every single bar up here has Molson Canadian, either on bottle, in a bottle, a can, or on tap.
That's true. Although they're running out of Labatt Blue. I don't see Labatt Blue as much as they used to.
That's good, because Labatt... I'm not fussy on that. I would rather... If I'm going to go with macro like that, like the Molson Canadian Blue, I'm going to have Canadian over Blue any day.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
That, I mean, that's just me. That's my opinion, my palate. I mean, you guys, you know...
I'd go with a Labatt 50, but that's just, you know.
Oh, I'm my old. God, that's even worse. That's worse.
All right, I'm just saying
that's
that
like,
for...
That's like, hey, I don't listen to Ariana Grande. I'm going to go listen to Taylor Swift. Like, you're just getting worse as you go along here.
Yeah, well, you know, a Labatt 50 is, it's not good. But
it's old man beer.
Yeah, I just basically drink that because I feel like, you know, a guy my age should drink that. Anyway.
Fair enough. I mean, whatever. I can't argue with that.
Shane, thank you so much for coming down here.
It's awesome. It's
traveling down to the Terry Ale Basement Pub, tasting lounge and lodging. Shane's sleeping like right over there in a
literally like just behind the camera. Literally, Alan put out like a couple of hay bales. And kind of threw it out there, like, he's like, hey, man, this is where you're sleeping. I'm like, oh, like, really?
So if you want to stay here, you know, hit me up.
That's right.
All right. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers, guys. Dry,
really dry.
Dry. So dry. Very dry.
Yeah.
Dryness. Dryness. Dry.
Dry.
Very dry.